This is another one that's a little bit trickier. Red maple, which is also called soft maple or swamp maple sometimes, is often confused with sugar maple, and sometimes we just call them both maples, but they're actually really different. Red maple bark tends to be more of a bluish gray as compared to the sort of grayish brown with that whitewashed appearance that sugar maples have. If you remember, sugar maple bark is thick and it's held tightly to the tree, so you should never be able to just pop a piece of that bark off. Red maple bark is much thinner, and it can actually be really shaggy, so you can often easily just sort of pop a piece of that bark off like this. So when a red maple tree is young or when it's growing really fast, it'll almost look like American beech. So it'll have this perfectly smooth bark. As that tree gets a little bit older, maybe as it starts growing a little bit more slowly, that bark will start to break up and it'll become very chippy, even shaggy. And you'll even see those two different types of bark expressions sometimes on the same tree. So you'll see part of the trunk will be that really smooth, almost beech-like bark texture. And another part of the trunk will be shaggy, flaky, chippy. One of the tricks that we learned with aspen is to use the whole tree. So don't just look at the trunk of the tree and then decide what you think it is. Look all the way up to the top of the tree, see if you see any more clues as to what it might be. Sometimes with red maple, you'll look at the trunk and it'll be kind of generally chippy and flaky. But if you look further up the tree, you'll see that really smooth young bark. So with red maple, like sugar maple, we see that distinctive multi-pointed maple appearance, but the entire margin of the leaf in between those points is serrated, it's jagged. Whereas with sugar maple, the margin of the leaf between those points is smooth. Like sugar maple and white ash, red maple is opposite branch, so those leaves are coming off opposite one another across the twig. Unlike sugar maple, this twig, which this isn't even a fully matured twig, it's going to get much redder. The twigs are bright red, and the buds at the tip of the twigs are going to be bright red and round. By comparison, sugar maple, the twigs are straight up brown, and the buds are really pointy and brown. On a more mature red maple tree, the twigs at the top of the tree will be these big clusters of buds. And you'll actually, when there's no leaves on the tree, you can see them. It looks like the tips of the twigs are dipped in wax, that they each end in this big bulge, which is those clusters of buds, which is something that also will distinguish it from sugar maple. This is an example of the perennial target canker, sometimes called bullseyes, that red maple bark can form. So if you imagine, if this is the center of the bullseye, this is a concentric ring, this is a concentric ring, this is a concentric ring. So it won't be an entire bullseye, it'll just be the sort of that accent, that suggestion of a bullseye. Here's another example. If this is the center of the ring, here's a concentric ring, here's one, here's one, here's one. Not every red maple will have this target face bullseye appearance. But if you do see a tree whose bark is breaking up in this way, it's a red maple. It's a completely diagnostic trait. From an ecological perspective, sugar maple and red maple are really, really different. Whereas we'll only see sugar maple growing on these sites with rich soils, and while it's shade tolerant and long-lived, red maple will grow kind of anywhere. You'll see it growing in swamps, you'll see it growing on thin soils, acidic soils, rich soils. It's also relatively short-lived, so living 80 to 100 years as compared to sugar maples, 250 to 300 years. And red maple is also pretty intolerant of shade. So while sugar maple can grow in the understory of a forest, red maple needs bigger openings usually to establish and grow. Stay tuned for more Tree ID videos, and please like and subscribe.